Yesterday, City Manager Art Noriega made the decision to suspend Chief Acevedo for the reasons he has outlined. This was a difficult decision, and it marks the beginning of the end of an unfortunate episode for our city. I support the City Manager for weighing all of the factors involved and doing what he believes is in the best interest of our residents and our employees. Over the last few weeks, I've insisted in giving the manager the time and space to sort the situation out, and I truly believe he has done the best he can under very trying circumstances. While it is clear that Chief Acevedo has the qualifications and the experience to be an effective chief of police, it is also obvious that his personality and leadership style are incompatible with the structure of our city's government. The status quo, where a top city administrator is at war with the city's elected leadership, is simply untenable and unsustainable. This dynamic was unforeseeable, and while Chief Acevedo ended up not being a good fit for our city, I certainly wish him and his family the best of luck in the future.
What was it, because he exposed the corruption?
That's right.
In the city government?
So, exactly. I'm going to take questions. Glenna, go ahead.
So the manager wrote this pretty pointed letter and enumerated 8 points for the firing. Do you agree that those 8 points rise to the level of termination for this chief? Do you back that?
Yeah, I think the manager has a charter responsibility to document in a very detailed way why he is essentially suspending the chief, which is what the charter calls for. And the charter calls for very specific causes or all other reasonable causes, and that's what the manager had to do to justify his decision.
Do you, as the mayor, though, agree that the chief is responsible for those 8 points and that for those 8 points, you support his firing?
Yeah, I mean, I can go through all the 8 points with you. I'm not going to do that. Generally speaking, I think a lot of the points, if not all of them, are right on point, and I do think that they're accurate, and I support them.
And rise to the level of his termination.
Yes,
Mr. Mayor, are you aware of the package, financial package, or a severance deal?
Steve, I hear you back there. It sounds like your voice. I am not. My understanding is that the chief was offered to resign. I'm not sure how that plays into the possibility of his compensation or severance. So that's something that's going to have to be determined. The chief does have a right to a hearing, and my understanding is he's going to avail himself of that right. And my understanding also is that that hearing is being scheduled. There was some talk about it being scheduled on Wednesday. The chief, my understanding, has requested additional time, and based on the legal advice that we've received, he will be granted that additional time. So it's very possible that it will be on Friday. Let me take Anna from Spanish media.
Can you give us your thoughts on the 8-point memo detailing criminality by certain commissioners? What are your thoughts on that memo?
Para resumir,
gracias.
Los 8 puntos que pone el administrador, ¿usted cree que son suficientes para llevar a la despedida del jefe?
Sí, yo creo que el detalle que ha puesto en el memo el administrador de la ciudad de Miami, desafortunadamente, que es algo, una situación en cual hubiera sido mucho mejor si no estaríamos en esta situación. Y si, sin duda hubo la esperanza cuando se contrató al jefe, que nunca estuviéramos en esta situación. Pero desafortunadamente estamos aquí. Y no es sostenible para los residentes de la ciudad de Miami, que están enfocados en tantas cosas positivas, tener una situación en cual hay una batalla entre el jefe y los funcionarios electos de la ciudad. Desafortunadamente es la tercera vez en mi vida que yo he estado expuesto a una situación como esta, una vez cuando era joven, durante el tiempo de mi padre, con Don Warshaw, otra vez cuando era comisionado, con el jefe de Exposito, y esta vez. Y desafortunadamente no es sostenible tener una batalla entre ambos partidos.
You know, look,
this is not about fault, right? I think every elected official had the expectation and the hope that this would work out. I think anytime you hire someone, and there's no doubt that he was hired with tremendous qualifications. He was president of the Major Cities Chiefs Association, you know, chief of 3 successive large departments. So he was hired with a high level of expectation. And unfortunately, you know, not every hire works to your satisfaction, Peter.
Yeah, Mayor, you answered that one question. You expect the vote to go against him at this point, that there's a consensus that the city wants to get this behind them? Or?
Look, I don't want to talk about that, and I'll tell you why, Peter. It's the commission has a fiduciary obligation to listen to whatever his case is and make a decision based on the facts. I know because I had to go through it myself with Chief Acevedo, and it was a very contentious 20-plus hour hearing. I'm sorry, with Chief Exposito, and it was a very contentious 20-hour hearing plus 2-day, and we had to be objective. So I can't speculate as to what they're going to do. Hold on, Carlos. I hear you back there, buddy. Just give me a second. Go ahead.
¿Pudiera decir en español qué va a pasar ahora de aquí en adelante? Hablamos de un tema económico también. ¿Qué va a pasar?
Bueno, tenemos, el jefe tiene una opción de obtener una audiencia con la comisión, como yo tuve cuando yo era comisionado con el jefe Exposito, y tiene la habilidad de poner su caso de por qué no se debe despedir. Tengo entendido que él va a hacer eso. Le dieron a él la opción de hacerlo el miércoles y él ha pedido más tiempo, así que a base del consejo que hemos recibido de nuestros abogados, yo creo que le van a dar hasta el viernes, que es suficiente tiempo en lo que requiere la Carta Constitutiva de la Ciudad de Miami. Carlos, go ahead back there.
A lot has been said about your lack of absence, or your absence in this story.
A lot has been said about my lack of absence?
I'm sorry, about your absence.
It's okay.
Regarding this story.
Sure.
And I'm curious whether you think that criticism is valid. And to underscore things, it's my understanding that you were on vacation in the Caribbean on the weekend.
Yep.
And so I'm curious whether you think it's fair for folks to take issue with the fact that you were one of the strongest supporters when you brought him on.
Yeah. Well, look, my objective, Carlos, is to represent my residents and do the very best that I can. And sometimes that means that I have to lead from the front and be very vocal on certain things. And sometimes that means that I have to use my discretion and understand that their situations are very complicated. They involve allegations of corruption. They involve allegations of illegalities. And that requires care when you're discussing these kinds of issues. As to my personal life, I had my birthday on Wednesday, and I decided to spend some time with my wife and do some other personal things that I had to do. Thank you. Joey's going to be my last. Guys, Joey. Okay, Joey and Glenna, and then I'm closing. Go ahead, Joey.
The chief wrote you an 8-page memo where
yes.
they alleged that commissioners were interfering with police investigations
yep.
and interfering with city operations.
Yeah.
What do you make of that? What's your response to this memo?
Well, you know, I'm not an investigatory agency, and I am not a, you know, prosecutor. So I think you would have to ask them what their professional opinion is about that. I can tell you that I was not consulted on the drafting of that memo. He didn't ask me for my advice. He didn't tell me he was going to do it. And certainly I think, you know, I can't speak to his intent in why he did it. But I think when you throw down the gauntlet that way, you certainly set up a scenario that could be untenable, and that's certainly part of what's happening.
Do you believe him? Do you believe what he's saying is true?
Glenna, go ahead.
I'm
not going to opine on his allegations again. He has made allegations, and those are to be presumably analyzed by investigatory and or prosecutorial agencies. I'm not a prosecutor. I'm not an investigator, so I'm not going to render a professional opinion on that. Last question.
You chose Art Acevedo as a rock star police chief, yep. nationally known. While there was an internal process going on here,
sure.
you brought him in as an outsider to reform things that insiders might not reform. Mm-hmm. And now he's an outsider that doesn't fit in, and that's the cause of his firing. Mm-hmm. Wait.
Well, I think it's a little more complicated than that.
We got time.
No, it's okay. I think it's a little more complicated than that. I would say this. I certainly, and I think all the commissioners, at least when they were informed of the decision, were excited about the possibility of having someone of his caliber be here. And I think, unfortunately, you know, you want, you know, these situations always to work out. And they obviously haven't under the structure of government that we have. And we can continue to belabor this and continue to drag this out, but really for the benefit of the city, for the benefit of him and his family, for the benefit of our government functioning and not being distracted from the real work that we have to do, which is keep homicides down, which is make sure our streets are safe, and which is make sure that we're doing everything that we can to differentiate our economy and make it a city where everyone can be successful in. That's the trajectory of where I want to be thinking and going. And frankly, I think that's what we should be focusing on.
Déjame
leer el dicho.
Statement y se reconoce, por favor, si cometió un error trayendo a una persona de afuera, habiendo una comisión que evaluó que podía haber una persona de acá y ha dado, en todo caso, pérdida de dinero, pérdida de tiempo, y estamos todos aquí por eso.
Gracias, Rono. Ayer, el administrador de la ciudad de Miami, Art Noriega, tomó la decisión de suspender al jefe Acevedo por las razones que él especificó. Ha sido una decisión difícil que marca el comienzo del fin de un episodio desafortunado para nuestra ciudad. Apoyo al administrador en su contemplación de estos factores, teniendo siempre el interés de los residentes en mente. En las últimas semanas he insistido en darle tiempo y espacio al administrador para resolver esta situación. Creo que ha hecho lo mejor dadas las circunstancias. Mientras está claro que las calificaciones de Acevedo son amplias, a tu punto y pregunta, está claro también que su personalidad y su estilo de liderazgo son incompatibles para esta ciudad. No puede haber un enfrentamiento entre los oficiales electos y los líderes de la ciudad. Aquí hay una investigación criminal abierta y por ende no puedo comentar más sobre ese tema, pero hacia el futuro espero que llevemos de nuevo el foco hacia mejorar la calidad de vida y los servicios para nuestros residentes. Thank you guys.